Hi, welcome to show 290 something.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Now, you may wonder where we've been the last couple of weeks. After 6 years, we decided to give ourselves a Christmas break. We had the Christmas episode and didn't break. Now, that's partially driven by those fuckers on YouTube, because they've been difficult for the episodes before. And then I got a nasty letter, replied, then got a really nasty letter, got a bit panicked. But we're all right, I think, so hopefully this episode will play. So I think we're going forward, we'll give ourselves that break, because that one year, no one ever watches it anyway.
No, it's
that
true.
One brown
it's
box in there, because everyone's busy, turkey and sleeping on the couch watching James Bond, so.
Exactly.
You know, so, but anyway, we are back in style, with loads of news, more importantly, some cracking records. Chris, we've got
this
here.
Is the barcase.
It is.
It's lovely. Yeah, and this is Open Your Heart on this album here. Pretty cheap album to get, but this is lovely. There's a couple of real excellent tracks on this, so
yeah
it's a toughie to pick which one, but this is a bit of a rare groove classic, so it's very nice.
A beautiful, cheap album.
Totally. We like that.
Yes, we do.
So much more than an expensive album sometimes.
Yes, yeah. It's a delight.
Totally.
Yeah.
How was your Christmas, bud?
It was really busy. I ate every day for like so much, more than ever.
Yeah.
I ate more than ever.
I can't say that I did, but I probably did. And it's all those chocolates and twiglets and stuff like that. So I've actually given up sugar for over a week.
What's that?
It's hard, man, because I have sugar in my coffee. And having coffee without sugar when you're not used to it is disgusting.
That sounds like Chris's blues song right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I gave up sugar in October. Sugar and booze.
Oh, really? Yeah,
it was hard.
One thing at a time, Brad. One thing at a time.
Talking of your New Year's resolutions, why don't you make it a resolution to come along to the head nod at Son of Camberwell.
24th of January, I believe.
27th. Yeah. With me and Chris, the guest to our man, Mr. Higgs, our handman, Mr. Parker.
That's right.
We did it last year. It was brilliant. We are going to outdo ourselves this year.
We really are. Star spangled outfits, all sorts. Smoke machines,
yep.
Everything.
Yeah, we are going to be playing all your finest in funk, soul, and jazz and oddities around that. It's going to be wonderful.
Totally, totally.
So come on, that's free.
Exactly. And I believe there is even though this is a bit faded now, but there's a Beeline jam coming up in Bristol again. I think it's in February or March. And I believe there's going to be some special guests there and stuff like that. So hopefully I'll be there. No, I don't think it's going to be us. But we'll be there selling some records anyway. So we've got to pop down to that because it promises to be a good one.
And they're lovely guys, the Beeline.
Totally. You get hugs and kisses when you go through the door, right? It's lovely. It's really sweet.
True, yeah.
Anyway, next up. I can't remember which one we're going to play off of this. But anyway, it's Thomas Escobardo. And it's and the album's Disco Fantasy. I can't remember which one it is that we're going to play. But hey, I think it might be Soul Support.
I don't remember the name of it. It was nice.
Yeah. Yeah, this one. Being Disco Fantasy from the album Disco Fantasy.
Interesting noises.
Yeah.
It's coming.
It is.
Here it comes. Oh. There you go. Tough Cut isn't playing with us as well, is he? But he's coming down, I imagine.
I hope so. I hope he comes down.
I imagine Mr. Tough Cutness will come down.
Yeah, that would be nice. Yes.
Lovely to see him.
Totally. Yeah, this is nice, this.
Love it, Shin. Now,
yes,
every week, I mention the Shed Show. I'm going to mention it this week, because next week might be the last week you can go there.
Might be. It might well be shutting the shop.
Because Mr. Gibbs is in international demand as a model, and he just can't do both things.
That's so right. Marlborough man.
Yeah.
Purely ripping down the old shed and building this lovely new one with extra bedrooms above it and stuff killed us, and not enough people come in the shop to actually sustain the level of debt that we've got ourselves into. So we'll see, but
for people watching, we're not a couple. He he's not talking about us, he's talking about him and his wife.
We're not like Bert and Ernie or
we're not like Bert and Ernie or Walker and Wise.
But yes,
sadly, after a good few years,
5 or 6 years,
the shed shop is coming to an end, and so it will be full for the last couple of weeks. Absolute bargains.
It will be,
take it with you.
We really don't want to take half of it with me, and there must be about 10,000 to 12,000 records in there.
So if you help
a brother out.
So I'll give you a moment to digest that news. And if you want to come down and you've never been down before and you've been watching every week and thinking I should go down to the shed shop, if not just for a hug, then it's in South Harrow, opposite South Harrow Piccadilly Line Station in the indoor market. You go in, you walk down a couple of lanes and boom, it's down the right. You can't miss it. He's opposite the carpet guy, who, let me tell you, is probably devastated that Chris is leaving.
He has. He's been howling.
Yeah, howling. There you go. So just follow the howl and you'll know where you are.
Follow the howling.
So come down, take advantage of Chris's dire straits and buy some bargains.
Please do, yeah. I mean, obviously, if I win the lottery between now and then obviously I'll keep it, but...
Buy Chris a lottery ticket.
Yeah, if there is any way possible, then I will keep it open, but it's...
Looking unlikely.
Well, it's difficult because I'm going to have to actually go and get a real job, and there's no way I can leave the shop and go do a real job at the same time unless I look after kids and blah, blah, blah.
But so. You could just open the shop on a Friday and Saturday. It wouldn't be sustainable.
I did talk to the guy today, and he wants me to stay, and he said that if there's anything I can do, you know, maybe to sort of like help.
Without charging your rent.
Anyway, sorry, that was that. And next up, we've got Air Tone. This is Air 2 Fingers, and the track is Fingers. Great little track, this.
Yeah.
El Rada.
On CTI. 1973. Yeah. I can't remember what I was going to say.
No idea, bro.
I'm a bit tired, I've been out all night.
Bro's been up all night working
hard for the dogs. Yes. Yes, I have.
Anyway,
that's what I do. Yeah, this is cool. I like this a lot.
Yeah, it's cool. I mean, I had one of these in the shop and sold it to Mr. Brown, actually.
Mr. Brown, your lucky thing.
Yeah. Quadraphonic version as well.
Yeah, I never saw it in the shop.
I mean, it literally was in there an hour before he popped in and he swiftly took it out again.
This is literally the only record I've bought in about 2 weeks, and it's because it's Christmas time.
I haven't had any money to buy any records. I've had a few bits that have floated through that I paid for before Christmas that have just been turning up now, and a few other little bits that you pick up along on your travels, but honestly, I'm fucking broke, man.
I got a few records I'm sure I paid for that haven't arrived, actually.
You need to look into that, Bradley.
I keep forgetting to do that. I've done that a few times. Mm. Yeah. Anyway, I like this.
It's cool. Pretty cool. Very cool. Yeah. Next up, we played a track by this group many, many moons ago, but I've got the first or second album anyway. So this is the Rock Workshop, and it's good. Yeah, this is Bob Downs & Co. This track is called You to Lose. The other side, Spine Cop.
That's right, that was the name of the track, Spine Cop.
Should we flip it over? This is good as well.
This is good, yeah. Flip it over, Chris. Let's give it 2 for 1.
Let's flip her over.
That was the name of the track. Remember the Spine Cop. There you go. That'd do. Yep, nice. This is Spine Cop.
What a great name. It sounds like a library sort of name to
it. It does, yeah. It sounds like it must be a library track and an 80s bad action movie. Maniac Cop.
It's good. No, there's some good tracks on this.
Yeah, this album's like a cross between a jazzy rock band, a pub rock band, and a punk band.
Totally. With jazzy undertones.
Lots of jazzy undertones, yeah. It's a good album. Come on, that's a wicked track.
Yeah, this came in a couple of weeks ago, maybe just before Christmas. Probably the 23rd or something like that. And it's, I think it's cheap as anything, you know what I mean? But this looks like it's German, right? And it's on Harvest. and it's by a group called Eloy. Okay? And there's one killer track on this. Apocalypse, silent cries divide the nights, the vision burning.
In a strange way, yeah. Reminds me of Temptation. It's the beginning.
Love that tune.
I know you do.
But it goes into some nice heavy mood. A bit of DJ Shadow type stuff.
Yeah. When he was good.
Germany. No, Macedonia or something like that. And he pops in every now and then. He's a really nice guy. And sometimes he brings in a few oddities to trade for thrash metal and stuff like that. And this was one of them. So. And this the next one as well.
This is a cracker.
Yeah. Now the next one is a later Fairport Convention album. It's not one you see that often. Got all the geese.
Yeah.
Oh, nice little break on it.
As you can see, all these great records that get traded into the shop to sell to the shop, Chris Pitt's own. And then you wonder why he's closing the shop now.
Do you know what? I think a lot of this will be going back into the shop over the next couple of weeks. So.
What, really?
Yeah, I've got to make some money, man. You know what I mean? Anyway, there we go. So next up is, I think it's called Property Capers. It's nice drums.
Really good.
Sort of break, it's nice.
Very good.
Yeah. And there's no singing, so there you go.
Just unless you want us to sing.
We can sing.
We can make some lyrics up right now.
Could be. I don't think so.
No.
Yeah, it's cool. So there you go, that's it. Chest
yep.
20 papers from the Got All the Geese album.
Perhaps it's in the shop in the next couple of weeks. Come on down and find out.
It might be. Because I like it, but do I need to keep it? Oh, I don't know. Anyway, but either way, I'm not going to stop selling records, obviously.
No, yeah, so what is important to mention is the business is moving completely online.
Well, it will be going predominantly online, which means I'll probably be on Instagram a hell of a lot more, and
TikToks.
Yeah, that's right. Just woke up, what do you reckon?
Look at this crack at 12
inch.
Yeah. It's got a break in it.
Yeah, there is. But record fairs as well, I think that's probably going to be the way to go. So, there you go.
Record fair, Chris.
Yeah. Anyway, this is nice. Yeah, and it pretty much does this for about 5 minutes.
There you go, I like that.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, next up.
Oh, no. Sorry, because we're not actually at our break of the week yet, are we?
No.
I keep forgetting we've got a few too many breaks this week.
That's right. Now, our lovely friend Mr. Russell Payne has brought out this absolute killer from Bell Telefunk. Ain't no telling on the A side, but as ever, I always go for the B side with what he puts out. And Sister Moon is one awesome track. And he was sort of explaining that these were sort of like eventually became like the Daz band. So there's actually a track after this by Kinsman Daz as well.
Oh, that's right.
So, anyway, so here's Super Disco Edit's newest arrival, Bell Telefunk and Sister Moon. I didn't even realise it, so I need to go back and see if I can actually get them. This is beautiful. Yeah, get this now, because this ain't going
to
be around.
Yeah, I listened to this, but I didn't listen to this side. I meant to pick it up anyway, but no, definitely.
It's so good. Really good. Yeah, beautiful. Yeah. Really nice, really nice. Yeah, so from this, Daz album. I reckon Get Down With The Feeling is the track. It's got some nice drums.
That's why it's our break of the week, Chris. Break of the week.
Sounds like one of those breaks that was in the Wild style soundtrack. Yeah, now it sounds like that. What's it called? NWA break, but it's not. But it sounds like that. Very nice though.
It's a cracker.
Yeah, that was really good.
Yeah, not just a good break.
No. No siree, Bob. Well, soundtrack to the week.
Yeah.
It's just landed on my
doormat
yesterday. And I forgot I even actually ordered it to go to because it was such a long time ago. But it is turned up and I didn't even listen to it. But it's not bad. It's not really the sort of thing that we tend to play that much.
But perfect for theme of the week, though.
But perfect for theme of the week, yeah.
Yes.
And, yeah, anyway, so it's from this. And it's Free Fire, which is a motion picture to a film about assassins and stuff. But it's called by Jeff Barrow from Portishead and Ben Salisbury. Sound much more English than that, can it? Jeff Barrett, Ben Salisbury.
No.
But there you go. Anyway, but the track on this that I like is Do The Boot. It's not like it's almost got a break at the beginning as well, but it's more of like an indie sort of like rockabilly track. I really like it. Brilliant. So this is Wicked, this is our theme of the week. Yeah, so those of you out there who think it's going to be the next Portishead album, it's not. But it's not bad. Not bad.
There you go. So hopefully you can watch this and YouTube haven't taken us down. If they have, then well, I'm talking to myself. But hopefully you can watch it. Normally has resumed. Someone told me I had to put something at the beginning to stop it getting taken out. I'm not sure that would actually really work. I think that's just a YouTube thing for us. But the, one other thing I was going to mention is obviously 2 months ago I was 45 and a good friend of ours, a good friend of the show, said to me, then this conversation I actually had started it, but he's influenced me. It's nice to do it. I've got to do a 45 mix for 45.
Good idea, bro.
So I'm going to do it. Yeah, I've actually pulled some 45s out. And yeah, so I encourage all of you that are around that age and 45 to be doing the same thing. You've got a year.
I have.
Yeah.
I'm 44 next month.
Yes, he is. Yeah. But that'll be up in the next few weeks. And if for some reason YouTube do start to feel us, well, then we will be moving to the medium of SoundCloud. You won't be able to see our faces.
We'll
be able to hear the records and we'll maybe change the format of the show. Who knows?
Cool.
Cool.
I'm sure we'll be fine.
I'm sure we'll be fine, yeah. Cool, well, we'll catch you next week, hopefully. Bye-bye.